Hey guys, welcome to my new video. It's going to be about how to take over the world. It's actually incredibly simple. Don't let anyone else tell you otherwise. I'm actually a little sick too, so that's not great. So first of all, you're going to want to become president of the United Frickin' States of Frickin' America. Frick frack. With the new power that you have, you're going to want to stage a coup in a random third world country. All the ones in red are good options. All the ones not in red are not good options. They ain't good options. Don't try them. So you're going to want to stage a coup d'etat, right? You're going to want to put your friend as the leader of the coup d'etat. Then you're going to want to go to the international community, and you're going to want to tell them, guys, I'm going to stop the coup d'etat, because that's what everyone always sounds like. Because coup d'etats are bad, right? They're bad. So you're going to stage a coup d'etat, and the international community is going to be like, thank you, you're so cool. So you're going to tell your friend, hey, because your friend, he's going to listen to you. Just tell him, bro, we got to stop it. I'm going to invade you. So he's like, okay, I'm going to listen. And he's just going to call off the coup d'etat. So once capturing enemy stuff, you're going to find out some leaked military documents that say your enemies behind this. Some examples of enemies are Russia, North Korea, China, Iraq, etc., etc. So you're going to want to end the coup d'etat. Tell your friend, hey, tell the international community. I stopped the coup d'etat, and they're gonna be like, yay, thank you. And you're gonna be like, I'm gonna put in martial law, so that there's no more coups. And they're like, I don't care, you stopped the coup, yippee. And then during the martial law, you're gonna want to put your best friend as the leader of the country. And then with the end and repeat. That's how you take over the world. So some things I guess I failed to mention was that, to get more, recognition in the international community, you're going to, like, tell them that you're super amazing. You can use leaked classified military documents to, one, slander your enemies and tell the international community how great you are and your team is, and how bad the enemy team is. And then you can also, like, go use the leaked military documents as a casus belli, a justification for war, to go in on your enemies and be like, you guys did a coup, you're so bad. The end, I guess.